Okay, Jace, we're going to read another book. The title of this book is Earth's Water Cycle. Earth is mostly covered in water, and I want you to read to learn about the water cycle and how it causes weather. Okay?
Okay.
So this is the table of contents. You want to take a look at those table of contents? This shows what's going to be in the book. Let's turn to these pages here. Some pictures and some words here. You can take a look at those. Okay. And I lost my place for a minute. All right, I'm going to have you go ahead and read this out loud. I'm going to listen to you read.
What is the water cycle? The water cycle is a pattern in nature. The water cycle is happening all the time. Earth has a huge amount of water. The water is always moving. The water cycle moves Earth's water to different places. Water changes from as it moves. One part of the water cycle is evaporation. Evaporation happens when the sun warms liquid water. The water changes from the liquid water becomes gas. This is water vapor. We cannot see water vapor. We can feel water vapor on some hot days. Air feels dim because it holds large amounts of water vapor.
Okay. Good. All right. Let's have you turn to the next page. Yeah, that's a caption, isn't it? It tells about the picture. Good job. All right. You're going to start reading here.
Wait. Out loud?
Yeah. Yes. Good question. Yeah. I'm going to have you continue reading out loud.
The next part of the water cycle is condensation. The water vapor rises into higher, cooler air. The cooler air cannot hold large amounts of water vapor. Some of the water vapor comes liquid again. The clouds form. The clouds become heavy with water. Clouds cannot hold the water. The water becomes prescription.
All right, let's do this here. Okay, let's have your mom pause this for a second because I lost my place because I